Okay. So let me take you to. So reason number one, I was telling you why you should go for this carrier. Reason number one is given herein, that India is going to be manufacturing base and import export industry is going to grow by 500%. And after that, reason number two is this. This is one of the most vital information for you, that as of now, India is having around 10,000 registered custom brokers. Registered means they are licensed by the custom departments. So those who are raising the hands, please, please put in the chat box. I'm looking at the chat box continuously. Okay. So you can put your question, you can put your doubt there in the chat box. So there are around 10,000 licensed custom brokers. Anybody can work as a custom broker, but not properly. Because I'm going to share the information in the legal background about that. The law clearly says a person who has not been licensed as a custom broker shall not act as a custom broker. So first of all, that is not allowed. Number two, that is an offense. So that's why if you are having the authorization, there is a lot of opportunity to get the business otherwise also. So here, so around, as I said, around 10,000 licensed custom brokers are there, and how many persons they are employing? Some data is given here. Just read the data. How many people are employed by them? Can you read that? More than 5 lakh people are employed by these people. So what is the average number of
people? More than 5 lakh.
What is the average number of persons employed by every custom broker?
50.
Every person is having 50 people. So their percentage may vary. Somebody may have 5. Another person may have 500 people also. But average person employed by a custom broker is around 50. So you can imagine the volume of business they must be doing. And these are the people who are directly employed. What about indirect employment? Lots of people are engaged in the import-export industry. Otherwise, then through the custom broker, you cannot count the number of people who are employed indirectly in the import-export industry. Right? So that is reason number two. Now, taking you to reason number three, this is the number which I was talking about. How many new custom brokers are required? Till now, around 10,000 custom brokers. And during next 5 years, we will need 25,000 more custom brokers. Because this is the time when the import-export industry is bound to grow very, very fast. Government is going to give all types of incentives, all kind of opportunities for promoting import-export industry. And the purpose of promoting import-export is promoting manufacturing base in India. And the objective of promoting manufacturing is promote generating the employment. And booming economy is bound to be there. Despite the fact that during last 1.5 years, there is a pandemic, and most of the people are struggling with the carrier. Do you know that the collection of GST has continuously increased? How many of you are aware of what is the collection of GST during last 1.5 year, monthly basis? How much collection has been there?
3 to 4 crores.
Hmm?
3 to 4 crores.
3 to 4 crores. Crores means what?
I was not aware about this, but my mother told me this.
I tell you, every month collection of GST is around 1 lakh crore. How much?
1 lakh crore.
In this depressed economy, how much will be the taxes when economy gets normalized? Maybe 6 months from now, maybe 3 months from now, right? So this is going to be something very, very big, right? Expenses to become CHF, very, very nominal. Don't bother about the expenses. Think about where you want to go. Okay. So this is one of the best industries. So India will require around 25,000 new custom brokers. So even if there are 5,000 new custom brokers every year, still the vacancies are not going to be fulfilled and a lot more opportunities will be open. For getting 5,000 people as a licensed new custom brokers, how many participants should appear in the exam? you know, the passing percentage in the exam during last three attempts. What is the percentage of passing in the exam? Can somebody tell me what is the passing percentage?
At least 10%.
Around 10% people are passing. Why only around 10% are passing?
Huge coverage of syllabus.
No.
No. Because people are not prepared.
Simple reason.
Proper exposure.
They are not aware how to prepare.
Knowledge is not given.
Right? Number one, they are not aware how to prepare. Number two, people start preparing when exam is 15 days or 20 days or 1 month away. Is it a right approach to prepare?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
When you should start preparing?
Immediately, sir. On the day of admission.
At the earliest possible, that also I'm going to share here in this program, that when you should start preparing for the exam. Syllabus is not wide. Let me confirm it to you in the beginning itself. Syllabus is not wide, but in-depth knowledge is required.
Yes, sir.
In-depth knowledge is required. And if somebody is telling you that they can prepare you for the exam for, with a 30 hours coaching or 40 hours coaching or 50 hours coaching, let me tell you that they are playing with the career. This is not the exam which somebody can clear with 30, 40, 50 hours of study. Not at all. Not at all. Okay. So some preparation is required. Syllabus is not wide, but certainly in-depth knowledge is required, whatever syllabus is. Because I've been in the profession of preparing chartered accountants and company secretaries for the last 30 years. And compared to the syllabus which we do there, for students of chartered accountancy and company secretaryship and cost management accountant, this syllabus is hardly 5% of that. This syllabus for exam is hardly 5% of the syllabus which is there for CA or CS exam. So is it wide?
I am a chartered accountant, sir.
So you are already aware of?
Yes.
Right. So as a chartered accountant, you have gone through how many laws?
There are many laws.
N number of laws are there, and this exam is mainly focused about the customs. Right. So this exam syllabus is not wide. First of all, be very clear. What is required is in-depth knowledge of the subject. Okay. Now coming further, why you should choose this as a career. Reason number three I have given you. Reason number four, this is everybody is looking for financial freedom. What is the meaning of financial freedom?
5 lakhs rupees.
5 lakh rupees per day, per month, per week, what? Tell me.
We should deposit 5 lakh as a financial term to the bank as financial, a guarantee.
Financial guarantee. Freedom means?
When you stop working for money.
You can work as per your choice. You should not be working only for survival. That much business should automatically be there where you are not bothered about the survival. That is called financial freedom. So this career gives you that financial freedom, that much business will always be there. And you can always think about growing your business, expanding your business. That opportunity is offered by this career. But keep in mind that this is not a get rich quick scheme. This is certainly not. And about this, I'll put this quote. Can you read the quote? This is, there is only one way to get rich quick, but not through a get rich quick scheme. There is a difference. What do you understand by this? You see, I've been talking about that this is one of the best career. Lots of money is involved. Lots of opportunities are there. But this is certainly not a scheme where I can tell you that today you are registered for the course, tomorrow you become custom broker, and third day you become rich. Not at all. This is not that kind of a scheme. This is not. You have to make your career step by step, but certainly unlimited potential of growth is there. how to make the career, this is what I'm going to guide you. Okay, so huge opportunities are there. Some of the participants are keeping their background mic open. Let me mute all of them. I've done that. Okay. Thank you, Akash, for reminding. And if you can help yourself, friends. So if somebody is disturbing, you can always give him a reference that. Okay. So I was telling you how much time is required to prepare for this exam. Reason number 5. Preparation time required for the exam is 200 hours of serious work. 200 hours of serious work. No 30 hours coaching, no 50 hours coaching, minimum 200 hours. And in addition to 200 hours, you should also be appearing for the test papers. Test papers will be a part of the complete program. I'm going to explain you that little later. So minimum time required for preparing for the exam is 200 hours. Now tell me quickly, how many of you are willing to spend this much of time? Tell me quickly on the chat box. Write me. How many of you are willing to spend this much of time to make this career?
Me, sir. We can invest.
Go ahead. You see, anybody thinking that this is a cakewalk, this is not. Right? So anything which is going to give you comfort in the future is not going to be easy now. Right now, little extra effort and this will give you comfort for the lifetime. What you will choose, comfort now or comfort later? That is also a very important decision. Tell me.
Comfort
now or comfort later?
Later.
Right. Because right now, in next 1 year till the exam, if you are ready to go through the process, then your whole life becomes easy. Enjoy for this 1 year and struggle for the remaining life. Or work during this 1 year and enjoy for the remaining life. Choice is yours. What do you want? Struggle now?
Work. Yes, sir.
Right. So the question is, are you ready to really go through the process in this 1 year? If you go through this, then I can tell you that it is very, very good opportunity to become custom broker because the government is also looking to get more and more people in the profession right now. Position will not be same after 3 years. Right now, government wants more and more people to come in this line. Difference between G card and F card. Okay, I'll tell you what is G card, what is F card. F card is actually a custom broker. Minimum eligibility for becoming CHS. There is no age limit. There is no age limit for becoming the custom broker. And as far as eligibility is concerned, I'm going to explain you complete regulation under which this course is done. Right. So when I do that, that will also give you the test that how the whole course I complete. Qualification, I'm going to answer that. Please wait. Okay. So every question will be answered. What is the eligibility criteria? How you can prepare? So everything is going to be there. Then 12th, can I become CH? Gajendra, sorry, right now you cannot, but yet there is a way out. Now the custom clearance has become the faceless clearance. What is the requirement of a custom broker in the scenario? Now a custom broker is the person who knows the custom law in detail and lots of things are there. So faceless does not mean that his requirement is over. Like in the income tax assessment has also become faceless. But do you require a chartered accountant for the purpose or not? Right. So do not assume that once the things become faceless, you don't require this person. This person's presence will always be required. So the question is coming, what is G card, F card? So G card is a junior position. A person, F card holder, he is a custom broker or he is referred as a custom house agent, CHA. So earlier, up to 2013, the concept was CHA, custom house agent. And after that, it has become custom broker. It is one and same thing, no change. And it is also referred as F card. Okay. Under this F card holder, a G card holder can work. And for being a G card holder, only requirement is that person is employed with the under the custom broker. And then he passes one exam, that is a junior level exam, and then he becomes a G card holder. after a person is a G card holder, work for 2 years, and a person becomes eligible to appear for custom broker exam. But that is for the people who are not directly eligible for appearing for this exam. There is eligibility criteria directly for appearing. So I'm coming to that. Just wait for some time. So I told you that this is 200 hours of preparation work required. 200 hours serious work. Thereafter, prepare or appear for the test. As many test papers you do, your confidence level goes up. Your chances of clearing the exam becomes higher. 10% people pass the written exam, and half of them are going to get the license. Reason being, because after the written exam, there is a viva. So I'm going to explain that. G card, Sonal Gaur, yes, I will explain you. Just wait for some time. Okay. So based on that, here comes when you want to start. If you start now, exam is at the earliest is going to be in the month of January, not before that. So if you start preparing now, you have to invest really 1 hour per day. If you invest 1 hour per day, chances of getting the license are very high. If you think of starting after 3 months, then what will happen? You will have to work for minimum 3 hours per day. And if you're already employed, you're already working, then getting 3 hours for the serious study work is going to be difficult for you. And if you think of starting after 6 months, then forget the chances of appearing in the exam, because then you have to work for 10 hours a day, which is practically very, very difficult. So when you want to start? Tell me when you would like to start.
Now, today.
Now.
You have to start at the earliest possible, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you have to start it the earliest possible, because that much delay, if you think of getting it done later, then that is going to affect your chances of clearing the exam very, very risky. So all the participants who are raising the hands, please write in the chat box. Yes, Bachelor or MBA. Yes, I'm going to explain. Please wait. All right. So I'm coming to that. So I'm taking you step by step. So right now, I have given you that how much time is required to prepare. And once you are willing, then we go ahead. But let me tell you one thing more, that whether you are eligible now or not, if you think that you want to make a career in this line, chances are there. So if you're directly eligible, then there is a direct way. But if you're not eligible, then there is a route through the G card. I'll tell you that also. Just wait for some time. I'm coming to that. So here is the procedure to become a custom broker. So this procedure I'm going to explain you on the board. So for this purpose, I wanted to write you to write on the notebook. So procedure for becoming a custom broker.
Yeah.
Procedure.
Sir, please off all the cameras, sir.
Participants, I'm putting you all on mute. Whenever you have a question, you can unmute yourself. Okay? So in the procedure, first thing is to check your eligibility criteria. Right? Now, eligibility criteria, primarily, this requires post-graduation. In post-graduation also, MCOM or a professional degree, either CA or CS or CME or LLM or MBA. These are requirements. Can you read on the board clearly?
Yes, sir.
Sorry. So these are the eligibility criteria that post-graduation only MCOM. If somebody is a postgraduate like MA or some other subject, then the person is not directly eligible. If any of these qualifications are there, person is directly eligible to appear in the exam. And
sorry
this,
to interrupt you, sir. I have a question.
Yes, please. Tell me.
Sir, I have done PGDM in marketing and international business. So can I eligible for this exam?
Prima facie, it says postgraduate.
Okay? But it is diploma, postgraduation diploma.
I'm coming to that.
Okay, sir.
For that, right now, you can write to this center which conducts the exam and get a clear-cut answer from them in writing. Because it is a postgraduate diploma, let me tell you that this is not eligible for the exam. But if they confirm you are eligible, because government is relaxing this criteria slowly for the time being, and if they confirm you are eligible, then certainly you can write. Okay. And if somebody is not eligible, then what is the way out? Still, can somebody get into the field? Yes. If not eligible, then process is through G card. Of course, this is a lengthy process. G card is another exam conducted, another license granted by the custom department. For that, first of all, you have already to be working with a custom broker. Then you can get the G card license. Then work for 2 years as a G card holder. Then you are eligible to appear for CHE exam. So G card and 2 years experience. But that is a long term process. So if you're directly eligible, this is a better criteria. If not, still you want to make a career in this, then the route will be this one. That is number one. The next thing is, this is about the eligibility. What is the syllabus in the exam? Some of you were saying that it is a very vast syllabus. Once again, tell me, is it a vast syllabus? It is not. This syllabus, in the exam, syllabus can be divided in two parts. First part, around 80% question are going to be from this part. Around 80% questions are going to be from this part, and then we have remaining 20%. So why I'm putting around is because the government has not given that this is exactly 80%, this is exactly 20%, plus minus 5% can always be there. Now this 80%, the three main subjects are there. One is the Customs Act. Keep on noting, that will be helpful to you. The Customs Act. Number two, the Customs Tariff Act. Number three, Foreign Trade Policy. These are three subjects which cover 80% of questions in the exam. So one of the participants here, he said he is a chartered accountant. What's your name?
Gaurav. C.A. Gaurav.
Okay. Now you can tell me, with this syllabus, is it a wide one?
Not really, sir.
Not really wide. Yes, it is not really wide syllabus, because in your paper, this was only one portion.
It's only 25 marks out of 800 marks.
Exactly. For chartered accountancy, when you appeared for 100%, 100 marks paper, this was only 25% only.
Yes.
And this 25% is going to be 100% in this exam. So is it a wide syllabus?
No, sir. No.
It is not.
And compared to other subjects, this is very easy.
Very easy. Very easy. But what is needed is So here is my question is, if I got a G card, postgraduate, after going the postgraduate, is it eligible to write F card exam? What is 80%? So in the exam, 80% questions are going to be from this area. Around 20% are other areas. Which are other topics? Let me tell you. First is GST. Thereafter, some more questions are going to be from PEMA. The exam is conducted by National Academy for Indirect Taxes and Narcotics. So the third topic is narcotics. Fourth topic is about arms and ammunitions. And then we have miscellaneous provisions. So these topics, GST, FEMA, narcotics, arms, ammunition, these will give you another 15% questions in the exam. This is the percentage of the questions in the exam. And 5% are going to be from miscellaneous category, for which we cannot give you exactly from which part those are. So up to 95% will be given herein.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
FEMA full form, sir.
Hmm?
FEMA full form.
Foreign Exchange Management Act. I'm sorry. That is Foreign Exchange Management Act. MBA from IGNU is eligible. Yes, very well eligible. Okay. So this is Foreign Exchange Management Act, because import export is dealing with the foreign exchange. So how the money should come, how the money should go out, when it should come, when it cannot, what kind of declarations are required, and how the RBI, what is the role of RBI in the process of import-export, when you require RBI permission, when you don't require permission, everything comes from Foreign Exchange Management Act. In a GST, particularly goods and services tax, what is important is when you import the goods, the IGST is payable, and what to do with that IGST, whether credit is available or not. Distance MBA is eligible. Yes, it is eligible. No problems in that. MBA degree should be there, whether it is distance learning or regular class, that is not a difference for the purpose of exam. Arms and ammunition, yes, these arms and ammunition import, that is also governed by this. MCA PG is eligible or not. So there's a professional degree, so that should be eligible, because that is not said that only these degrees, those degrees are eligible. There's a postgraduate professional course, so MCA certainly a professional course should be eligible.
Sir, apology. Sir, extremely sorry for disturbance. सर मैं ये जानना चाह रहा था कि 110% आप बोल रहे हैं कि ये जो डिस्टेंस लर्निंग का जो MBA है वो एलिजिबल है.
ओके जस्ट अ मिनट. ओके
ओके
मैं आपको दिखाता हूँ मैं क्यों बोल रहा हूँ. वो
नहीं सर, मैं आपके ऊपर यकीन कर रहा हूँ सर, ऐसे बात नहीं है. लेकिन क्या है, मैंने सुना है कि जो डिस्टेंस लर्निंग का जो MBA होता है वो कंसिडर नहीं किया जाता है. मैं इसके लिए बोल रहा हूँ सर.
नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है
सर. मैंने 2 साल अपने बिगाड़ दिए.
बिल्कुल बिगाड़ दिया आपने, बिकॉज यहाँ तो सीधा सीधा एमबीए लिखा हुआ, वहाँ कहीं लिखा ही नहीं है कि इट इज अ लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस, इट इज अ डिस्टेंस और रेगुलर कोर्स.
ओके. थैंक्स सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच.
एंड एवरी पार्टिसिपेंट कैन ऑब्टेन अ कॉपी ऑफ कंप्लीट रेगुलेशंस फ्रॉम मी राइट नाउ. देयर श्रुति, प्लीज शेयर अ लिंक ऑफ द ग्रुप. श्रुति, शेयर द लिंक ऑफ द ग्रुप. So in the chat box, a link is going to come for the group.
Sir, on the
Hello, sir. This is Abhijit Patil.
Sir.
Sound Hello. Bully. Hello.
Sir,
are you there?
सुनाई दे रहे हैं सर आपको. सर वो जो सिलेबस के नीचे जो 80% बगल में जो लिखे सर दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है सर. प्लीज वन सेकंड प्लीज.
अभी दिखाई दे रहा है. एनीवे सो
नेक्स्ट थोड़ा है जी.
द वन
नहीं सर, वो समझ नहीं पा रहा सर.
बीटेक
सर वो बीटेक के बाद आप क्या लेके सर
बीटेक इज नॉट एलिजिबल एज ऑफ नाउ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन इज रिक्वायर्ड सो आई सेड 80% क्वेश्चंस लेट मी ऐड हियर
हेलो सर
यस प्लीज
सर मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी गिव्स एमएमएस इन प्लेस ऑफ एमबीए सो दैट्स एलिजिबल
दैट इज एलिजिबल यस दैट इज एलिजिबल
एंड एनी स्पेशलाइजेशन मार्केटिंग इज आल्सो ओके
whether it is human resources or marketing doesn't make a difference it, ultimately it is a postgraduate in management
thanks a lot sir
okay so 80% questions in the exam are going to be from this area
hello
yes please
hello sir
hello
sir I'm an advocate from Gujarat
LLM?
Am I eligible LLB advocate
no go through LLM okay So,
hello, sir.
Hello.
Sir,
I am Sumitra.
Narcotics के नीचे लिखा है हमने arms and ammunition और फिर आगे लिखा है miscellaneous.
Sir, I have one question.
Yes, please.
Actually, I am LLB, but they have said in eligibility that a 1 year diploma from the customs are also eligible. Hmm. So, is there any institute in the India that provide this postgraduate diploma that is eligible for this course?
Mumbai University conducts a diploma course for import-export procedure that is 18 months. There are other universities Mumbai also University. Which conduct the diploma for 12 months, 18 months. So, rather than doing that diploma, rather I will recommend go for MCOM or do MBA. That is much better. Okay. So now explaining you once again. And towards the end, I'm going to share my personal contacts. Okay. So if you have any doubt, keep in touch with me. I will be answering to everyone on one-to-one basis. How many of you have joined the group? The group link was shared in the how many of you have joined?
I joined, sir.
Join that quickly so that whatever your questions are, I will answer everybody's question. Quickly join the group. There is nothing, you're not going to lose anything by joining the group, but certainly you can get more and more information therefrom. So here coming again. Now the question is how many questions are there in the exam? How to go ahead about preparing that? So I said 80% questions are going to be from this area, 20% are going to be from this area. Now this miscellaneous. Now, this miscellaneous questions may be from copyright, may be from patent, may be from trademark, may be some other law. You will never know from which area those are. In this exam, passing marks are 60%. Passing is 60% marks. Right? So, this 5% is a matter of chance. By chance, if you know the answer, that is yours. If you don't know the answer, forget that, you don't have to attempt that question. Okay? Now, all this exam, all the questions
sir, in
the
exam. Any negative marking?
Coming to that. There are 150 questions in the exam. How many questions are there? 150 questions. And how many you should be answering correctly for passing the exam?
90
questions you have to answer correctly. Okay. Oh, sorry. 90 questions, not 90%. 90 questions you have to answer correctly. Okay. And for every correct answer, how many marks are there?
Three marks.
Three marks are there. Right. How many marks are there for wrong answer?
-1.
For wrong answer, there is -1. So negative marking is there. Any negative marking for the questions not answered? Any negative marking? No. There is no negative marking for a question which is not answered. Right? So we must be having some participants here who have already appeared in the exam and they have not cleared. Is there anyone here? How many participants have already appeared for the exam before? Tell me quickly, how many of you have appeared?
No, sir. Never. First time.
First time. You see, what is the mistake committed? What is the mistake? The mistake is the person who is appearing in the exam, he goes on taking the risk without knowing the correct answer. And for every wrong answer, what happens? There is So, if you do not know the correct answer, should you answer that question? Should you answer that question?
No, sir.
Not at all. Not at all. Don't take any chance. This exam, for answering 150 questions, how much time is there?
3 hours?
No, this is?
150 minutes.
2.5 hours. Right. So 2.5 hours is equal to 150 minutes. So for every question, how much time you are getting? 1 minute is there for every question. Right. For that, you have to practice a lot in advance. Otherwise, if you don't have a confidence of answering the multiple choice questions, this is the area where the time is lacking. Practice is required in advance. And MCQ questions are such which can be prepared at any number of times. Any number of questions can be prepared. Whatever your practice is, that will be considered to be less. Right. So once you know the answer, then there is sufficient time. But if you don't know the answer, a lot of confusion is there. So how to prepare? Let me give you some guidelines. Number one, read the subject in detail. Detail means every line of the syllabus should be known to you because it is MCQ based, and on every line, one new question can be framed. Number two, practice MCQs. You have to do a lot of practice. Only knowing is not sufficient. A lot of questions you have to answer. Keep on practicing. So, and when you keep on the, when you do the practice, you get to know a lot of new things also out of the topic which you have already studied before. Number three, in the exam, what is to be done? Attempt 100 questions with 100% accuracy. Yes, all are MCQ multiple choice questions. No age limit. No age limit for appearing in the exam. Okay? But number of attempts are fixed. You cannot appear for more than 6 times. And 6 times is a big number. National Academy for Customs, Indirect Tax and Narcotics. Yes. The exams are conducted by NASIN. You know? Qualification for G-Card. There is no minimum qualification. If you are working with a custom broker, you can appear for that exam and get a license. Anyway, so attempting 100 questions correctly. So till you have answered 100 questions correctly, please do not answer any question about which you are not sure. This is where the mistake is committed, that the students try to attempt 100% marks and despite not knowing the correct answer, because of negative marking, they end up losing. how to be sure with 100% accuracy that whatever you are answering, that is perfect? Only practice tells you. And every time you practice, you get to know them how much you are scoring. More you score, more confidence you get, and more perfection is there. Okay. So till you have done this, don't attempt any question about which answer you are not sure. Now, when you have done 100 questions correctly, out of 100 questions, how many marks you can get? 300 marks. How many marks are required for passing?
270.
270 are required for passing. Okay. Now, how much extra marks you have for pass? 30 marks. Right. Now you can attempt at least 30 more questions. So even if answer goes wrong, still you are safe. My suggestion will be, if you prepare well, then answer only those questions about which you are absolutely sure. No one is allowing to join under CHA. For that, you have to speak to me on one-to-one basis. Who will give you an opportunity? Okay. No one is keeping the place ready. No age limit for G card. No age limit for F card. No limit for being a custom broker. Okay. So my suggestion will be, never attempt a question about which you are not sure with 100% accuracy. Focus on this and your exam is clear. Now for preparing this, what is required? You have any questions on this till now? Any questions? Difference between the custom officer and custom agent. Custom officer is certainly a government officer. This person is a licensed by the custom department to act between the custom broker and the custom department and the customer. Any MTech, yes, MTech is eligible, very well eligible. Oral interviews, coming to that. So this is the first part of the process which we have completed for passing the exam. MTech is certainly eligible. What is seaman? That is a person who is working on the ship. And how much would be the fees? That I'll come a little later.
Hello?
Yes.
Sir, is there any classes, I mean, different levels of F card?
Different?
Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3.
So some personal talk is there, so let me stop that. So first is passing the written exam. Next step is appearing for oral viva. So in the viva, the main focus is, this is more about your interest in exam industry. Chances of questions being from the law are less, because that has already been tested before. What they're going to test in the viva exam, what is your interest? Are you serious about this profession or not? Or this is just a chance that you have cleared the exam, so you should get a license. No, you will not get the license unless you are thoroughly prepared for this. So interest in the industry. And number two, are you aware about the procedures? So in the viva, they will directly ask you the procedure questions. Where would I fill the form? I'll tell you a little later, right? So procedures will be asked about the import-export procedures, procedure about claiming the rebate, procedure about claiming the duty drawback, procedure about the clearances. So are you aware of the procedures? If these things are there, then viva is cleared, and after clearing viva, license is given to you. Now, this is one area where students fail to answer correctly, and this I will train the people after passing the written exam. So this is two-step process. First step first step is written exam, and step number two is Viva. So in the two steps, person becomes eligible to get a license. Not taking you to something more. So this is what I have already shared. 6 attempts and no age limit is there. Okay. Now, so after passing the exam, after having the license, big job market is also open. And if you want to practice independently as a custom broker, that is also open. This is one of the screenshots which I have taken yesterday from Google. How many openings are there for custom brokers in India? You can see how many openings are there as of now. No case laws. No case laws for this exam. Right? So job opportunities are enormous. If you don't want to practice as a custom broker, you don't want to do the business, but you want to get in the employment. Every company which is an import-export is looking for the people who are having the license as a custom broker. Every company. And existing custom brokers are looking to employ the people who are clearing this exam. This is lots and lots of opportunities are open. Yes, this is CBLR exam. So this is about the opportunities open. And this is the average salary which is available after passing this exam. And you understand the meaning of average. This is also taken from Google. This is taken Salary Expert. You can Google yourself and check what are the average salaries available to the custom broker. This is from the fresher point of view. Fresher average salary coming to around 7.5 lakhs. And experience that depends upon how much you perform, the salary keep on growing. And those who want to work independently as a custom broker, there are multiple avenues of income. Now I need some participants who are already working with the custom brokers. Who are the people here working with the custom brokers? Do we have somebody here?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
So those who are working, please tell other participants that how much these are the opportunities open which I have written. Are these correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Definitely.
So a custom broker does not have income only to act as a custom broker. Multiple opportunities of business are there along with custom broker. So if you're not a custom broker, other opportunities are less. If you're a custom broker, other opportunities also grow. And warehousing opportunities with then freight forwarding, then clearing forwarding, import export advisor, import export business, merchant exporter, insurance. So many opportunities are open. Okay. So many opportunities are open to work as a custom broker. Okay. So see here, as a custom broker, how many opportunities are there? A clear-cut opportunity of employment is always there. So those who don't want to take any type of chance in the life, they can take up directly full, regular full-paid employment. And then another is working as a custom broker. Now, when you are working as a custom broker, multiple avenues of income are there. As a custom broker, it will always be there. As a warehousing, you can have your own warehouse. Then at the same time, there is a clearing and forwarding. At the same time, there can be a merchant bank, merchant exporter. Then Exim advisor. And in fact, telling you frankly, I cannot write everything. What are the opportunities open? Lots of things depend upon the individual, how much he wants to work, unlimited opportunities. But everything is related to what we are already going to talk in this syllabus, open industry, right? So there is, So lots of people still have not joined this WhatsApp group. I suggest Chartered Engineer. Yes, you can very well appear for Chartered Engineer. Join the WhatsApp group. I will be sharing lots of additional information. Plus, what will happen is that whatever is left out in the webinar today, whatever I cannot answer as of now because of limited time, that I can answer in the groups for the benefit of all. So join.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, in the opportunities for custom broker, you mentioned that individual, OPC, LLP, company, firm. I mean, yeah. How does company and can get a license?
Those are different forms of business setup. As an individual, you can work in your name. You can create a one-person company under the company law, that is OPC. You can have a partnership firm. You can create a limited liability partnership. You can create a private company. That is a matter of choice. So lots of things are there which you can create in the while doing the business of your own. And what I'm saying is that by chance, if anything is left out, which is not answered today, that I will be answering in the group continuously. So that's why I want everybody to join the group. Don't leave the chance. And once the capacity of the group is full, then it is gone. And lots of people are joining it fast. Okay. So is there any question right now about the opportunities open?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, tell us about the oral. Do you write the procedure they will ask the question for?
Procedure plus your interest in the field. Are you really interested? And the procedures about the customs. In the exam, they don't ask you about the procedure. They ask you about the law. In the Viva, they can certainly ask you about the procedural part.
So if we clear the exam, then how we will know about the procedure?
I'm going to teach you in this preparation itself. Import-export procedures also.
Okay.
Thank
you.
Sir, what are the weightage of Viva?
Sir,
what are the weightage of Viva first?
Viva is altogether independent. That has nothing to do with the main exam. This is right now we are talking about passing the written exam, which is 60%. And all the people, those who clear the written exam, 50% of that clear the Viva. 50% people generally do not. Reason being, because they don't know what is to be prepared for Viva. If they know little bit, they will also pass.
So,
you will guide us about the Viva,
no? Certainly, it is a part and parcel of this program.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So,
sir.
Yes, please.
So I'm working in a freight forwarding company for more than 3 years. Sir, but I doesn't know any of the CHA activities. I'm into the customer service and sales department, but some of the CHA person involved in the preparation of ICE into the ICE gate activities and preparing the import status and many things, but I don't have any practical knowledge on how to prepare any import filing and other things. It will be affected in the Viva because I doesn't know any of the CHA activities directly preparing for the exam and going to effect.
When I teach you the process of import-export, that documentation process, there are lots of things will be answered. And let me tell you one thing, that when you go for Viva, be very, very open and clear. If you know the answer, tell them yes. If you don't know the answer, say clearly no.
Okay.
Because they are very senior people. And only by one small answer, they will understand whether you really have the knowledge or not.
Okay.
Right. And they're ready to hear, listen, no, but they want the people who are interested in knowing the subject. So that's why the eligibility criteria is that way. So first of all, they check the people who are already professionally qualified and they are willing. They are taken only.
Okay.
So these are few examples I have given you that as an individual, you can have individual work as an individual or OPC. OPC stands for one person company, LLP, that is limited liability partnership. And you can have a partnership firm or you can create a private company or a public limited company. Anything that you want to create, and these many business opportunities are open as a custom broker.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, once you get the license, what is the duration and what is the procedure to renew the license?
Okay. Now, custom broker license validity period. So this license is valid for a period of 10 years. Once you clear both the things, written exam as well as Viva, license is granted to you for a period of 10 years. After 10 years, this has to be renewed, and every time renewal is for 10 years. No further exam. Renewal is required every 10 years. Okay. And by chance, if you are not willing to work as a custom broker, But if you have a license to act as a custom broker, certainly you can become a director in some company and that company can work as a custom broker on your behalf. You can become a partner in some partnership firm and then somebody else can work on your behalf. That is another opportunity of being a sleeping director and a sleeping partner as a custom broker. Tell us about your class. Yeah, Gaurav, I'm coming to that little later. Just wait. First of all, let me give you the complete information. Course will come later. What career opportunities are eligible? So did I answer your question about the career opportunities?
During renewal, is it just only the process or we need to go through any exam or anything?
No exam.
Just the documentation.
Only documentation part and a small fees, that is the renewal for 10 years.
All right. Okay.
And one,
sir, another thing.
What is this?
There is opportunity in abroad.
Any? Opportunities abroad.
Yes, sir.
You see, custom procedure remains same in the all over the world. Only difference is the custom law will be applicable different. So you have to study the law of that country. That is the only difference. Otherwise, this is one law. This is one thing, the import export, where the procedure throughout the world are same. Even custom law is also the same. Same to the extent of 98%. 2% difference can be there in different countries. So procedures all over the world, procedure law all over the world, that is same. So if you have a license here, you may not work in India. You can certainly go abroad and start working with somebody else, but as an employee there, not in the private practice. You can work for some big custom brokers in some country outside India. So here, as far as the regulations are concerned, I wanted to share the complete regulation, but that text file I can send you in the group. And once you've gone through that, I can certainly answer your questions. Eligibility criteria, I have already spoken. So everybody is a resident. Everybody is already 18 years plus age. Everybody and about the qualification that I have already discussed with you. And if you have any further question, we can certainly talk about it after going through the regulation. Procedure, one is written exam, another is Viva. Then you get the license. The validity of the license is 10 years. And after 10 years, renewal is required. And for renewal, no further exam. And you can work independently or you can work as a partnership firm. You can work as a company. And if you're not directly working, then you can be a director or partner in some other organization. They can work as a custom broker in your name. That is another business opportunity open.
Sir?
Yes, please.
I was actually going through the customs exam through on the website. So what all you said, that there's a process of online on exam and offline face-to-face interview. But the eligibility, what you said, the educational eligibility, everything went. But apart from educational eligibility, there was some other points like some bank, corporate bank or something. XYZ.
Nothing. That is required at the time of getting the license. So you should have the financial viability. And that is amount of 5 lakhs. That is not to be paid. That is only amount shown in the bank account. That you have that much of amount if required.
So do we need to open account in corporative bank?
No. It's any bank. Any bank.
Okay. Thank you.
And that is required at the time of applying for the license, not in the beginning.
Achha, okay. Matlab, test, matlab online test pass hone ke baad mein, before apna matlab license milne se pehle unhe bank guarantee dikhana barabar
dikhana padega bas aur kuch nahi wo paisa aapka aapke paas hi rahega unko dena nahi hai
acha thank you
okay
so what is the average CHA will be earning individual CHA
average CHA will be earning so how many are there who are working with the CHAs yahan par kitne log hain jo CHA ke sath already kaam kar rahe hain कुछ लोग हैं
आई थिंक नॉट लेस देन 5 लाख पर मंथ इफ दे आर डूइंग बिजनेस गुड
जब बताइए कि सीएचए का एवरेज अर्निंग क्या होगा अगर कोई व्यक्ति है जो सीएचए काम कर रहा है तो
आई नो द सीएचए सीएचए इज गेटिंग 5 लाख पर मंथ नॉट लेस देन दैट
मैं उन लोगों को भी जानता हूं जो लोग साल में 2 करोड़ रुपए भी सैलरी ले रहे हैं है ना और मैं उन लोगों को भी जानता हूं जो 2 लाख रुपए महीने की सैलरी ले रहे हैं. तो देयर इज नो एंड अप टू विच यू कैन ग्रो इन दिस बिजनेस. गणेश, यस गणेश, नाउ आई वांट टू स्पीक टू यू. गणेश प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ.
यस सर, टेल मी सर.
आप बताइए आप सब लोगों को कि व्हाट आर द क्या क्या अपॉर्चुनिटीज बिजनेस में ओपन है एज ए कस्टम ब्रोकर.
सर वेरी सिंपल, अपना अगर इफ देयर इज अ गुड अपॉर्चुनिटी टू गेट क्लाइंट्स देन इवन 500 बॉक्सेस 1000 बॉक्सेस देन इट इज वर्ल्ड ओपन. 5-10 लाख 15 लाख 20 लाख भी कमा सकते हैं. बट क्लाइंट्स नहीं है तो अलग सा है ना सर, सिर्फ कस्टम ब्रोकर ही रह जाएंगे.
क्लाइंट लाने के लिए क्या करना रहेगा?
हेलो सर, मैं
देना पड़ेगा बिकॉज कस्टम क्लियरेंस इज ऑल अबाउट सर्विस.
ऑल अबाउट सर्विस, राइट? करेक्ट, वेरी गुड.
सो 100% सर्विस.
दिस इज सर, आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन. I just read on Google that it's written that you will have to work under some CHA for about 3 years.
नहीं.
ऐसा नहीं है.
नहीं नहीं ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. वो जी कार्ड के लिए है क्या? अगर आप CHA के
बाद 2 साल काम करेंगे. Starting for CHA CBLR, then you don't have to work under some CHA for any particular time.
No.
सर CFS में वर्किंग एक्सपीरियंस चाहिए या ऐसे ही चल जाता है सर? मतलब कंप्यूटर नॉलेज
की कोई जरूरत नहीं है फिलहाल तो. और जब भी ऑनलाइन हो भी रहा है तो ऑनलाइन में वो अपने आप आपको बताता जाता है व्हाट इज टू बी डन. एंड दैट इज कंप्यूटर नॉलेज नॉट गोइंग टू ऐड ए वैल्यू टू योर CV एज फार एज CHA इज कंसर्न्ड.
Sir? Rajesh ji, ek question hai. We will get the license for particular port or matlab overall?
All over you can work. Once you have a license, you can work all over. For everywhere, you need to get a special permission from the commissioner having jurisdiction in that area, and permission is granted very liberally.
Okay.
Sir, exam clear karne ke baad kitna time milta hai interview pe prepare karne ke liye?
Kam se kam 3 mahine.
तो उस पीरियड में आप गाइड करेंगे ना कि क्या प्रोसीजर है, कैसे क्या क्या क्वेश्चन पुट करेंगे उस प्रोसीजर के? और
जरूर करेंगे, लेकिन वो एग्जाम क्लियर होने के बाद. प्रोसीजर्स
प्लीज सर, प्लीज सर. PGDM जिनका हुआ वो दे सकते हैं क्या एग्जाम? मेरा क्वेश्चन सर, नेटवर्क ब्रेक हो गया था मेरा.
PGDM फिलहाल के लिए मैंने कहा था नेशन में आप डायरेक्ट मेल डालिएगा और वहां से पूछिए, वो लोग कंफर्म करते हैं क्या, बिकॉज़ दैट इज अ डिप्लोमा, दैट नॉट अ डिग्री. एंड दे वांट, एंड दीस पीपल वांट अ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट डिग्री. एट द सेम टाइम लॉट ऑफ लिबरलाइजेशंस आर कमिंग इन दिस एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया आल्सो. हो सकता है वहां पर आपको एलिजिबिलिटी मिल जाए, और अगर एलिजिबिलिटी एक बार मिल जाती है आप अपीयर हो सकते हैं.
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर.
सर जैसे मुंबई कस्टम्स से एग्जाम देते हैं, सी एन एयर दोनों का क्लियरेंस के लिए एलिजिबिलिटी हो जाती है ना?
मैंने आपका क्वेश्चन सुना नहीं, अभी मैं आपको आगे ले चलता हूँ. लेट मी टेल यू देयर. यस प्लीज
सर, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर अ कस्टम ब्रोकर्स इंटरव्यू. व्हेन दिस इंटरव्यू विल हैपन दिस ईयर? आई हैव क्लियर्ड माय रिटन एग्जाम 2 times.
अभी तक डेट नहीं आया है.
Okay, and sir, how can I take your help to get an interview session, interview training?
उसके लिए अब वेबिनार के बाद हम बात करेंगे.
Okay sir, okay.
Okay.
Yes, once we clear our CHA, can you work for any port?
Okay.
For the particular port.
आप किसी भी पोर्ट पर काम कर सकते हैं. आपको वहाँ के कमिश्नर से परमिशन लेना पड़ेगा. परमिशन आराम से दी जाती है.
We can work for multiple ports also.
Yes, yes, yes.
And one thing, sir, I want to know the revenue part. What I got to know, what are the if you have a client who is importer or exporter, as per his consignment, we'll be getting a commission. For example, it's like $100, $100. So what is your percentage for commission? So what is the process to calculate a commission?
What is the
procedure, or what are the expectations of percentage expectations?
This is a professional revenue, and the revenue depends upon your arrangement with the customer. It can be percentile, this can be fixed amount, this can be your retainership. Different modes of remuneration are there. So right now we cannot tell you at what percentage, right? So when the consignments are bigger, there is no percentage, there is a fixed amount. When the small consignments are there, then you can talk about the percentage. So different things are there. Okay. Now let me tell you about the course. See, time is running out. What is the time right now?
9:30.
Okay, so it is already 9:30. Let me tell you. I am giving you Customs Act, Customs Tariff Act. Foreign Trade Policy, GST, FTP, Arms and Ammunitions, Narcotics, whatever is there in the syllabus, everything is there. And all this is 100 hours of videos. And these videos are available 24/7 for one full year. Accessible on your mobile as well as on laptop. One full year. You can see any video any number of times. Right? The details are clear there in the chat box. Right now, you can click on that. You can directly go and check what are there in the course. So 100 hours of videos are there. In addition to that, there will be ...5,000 multiple choice questions for your practice. And if you practice this much, I promise nobody can fail in the exam. But you have to... Yes, please.
Sir, these 5,000 MCQs, they are segregated topic, I mean, topic-wise or question paper set-wise?
These are topic-wise.
Thank you.
Right. So you have to work on those. But... you have to practice file, again and again. Yes, please.
Sir, these are the pre-recorded videos or live training classes?
Pre-recorded. Hain. Abhi main uske upar aa raha hun aage. Main bata raha hun aapko kya kya hai.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So yeah. This is about the existing thing what you already have.
Excuse me, sir. FTP
yes, please.
Means what, sir?
Hmm?
FTP.
Foreign Trade Policy.
That is after custom tariff, FTP, GST and again FTP is there.
Achha, FTP dobara likh diya. Achha, mujhe FEMA likhna tha, shayad main dunga. Yes, I'm sorry. This is FEMA. Foreign Exchange Management Act. Dobara likhne mein a gaya. Okay. So, yahan par jo, these are 100 hours of videos are there. And that's why I told you minimum 200 hours of preparation is required. Because once you go through this, this is not enough. You have to revise some of the videos. Some of the things, some of the doubts will be there. Then some writing practice has to be done. Then these MCQs are there. That's why I want you to have minimum 200 hours of investment in this entire course. This is one part. Okay. Then after, other than this, I'm going to do webinars. There will be two webinars every month till your exams are there. Two webinars every month, and those webinars I will be touching upon every topic in a little faster way. So that is the complete revision of your syllabus once again. And whatever updations are coming, whatever doubts you have, whatever questions are there, everything will be answered in the webinar. So there will be two webinars per month. Other than this, I am always personally accessible. Whatever your doubts, whatever your question, I will be answering everything to you independently. Right? And what are going to be the topics in this webinar? Let me show you here. This is the list of the webinars which I'm planning to have. Basics of the Customs Act. Just read the list, which the topics which I'm going to do. MCQ limited for 1 year? Yes. The entire course is valid for 1 year. So these are the topics which I'm going to cover in the webinars. So you will be covering in the recorded videos. You will be covering with me in the webinar once again. So that will be a complete revision of the course twice. And other than this webinars, what else I'm giving you that is more powerful? I'm giving you one course. By way of bonus, number one, how to study. Have you ever been taught in any college how to study? Any school, any college?
No.
I'm going to teach you how to study. And this is valid not only for you, this is going to benefit the entire family. Number two, another bonus. I'm going to teach you speed reading. In addition to speed reading, how to enhance your memory. This course alone is sold separately for 3,000 rupees. This is coming to you in this course free of cost. How to study, this is a course which is sold worldwide. You can go and Google how to study course, what is the price of that course. Right, very few people in the world teach that course, how to study. Speed reading, webinars, all these are free to you along with the entire course. Right, and the course link is there. The course link is already shared in the chat box. Right now you can directly click the link and go and check what is there in. Okay. And other thing is that videos are continuously updated. Some way you will never find a video recorded two years before or 3 years before. Right now, I'm recording GST videos. Video recorded yesterday, also uploaded. Some of our participants have seen the latest videos on GST. So every time we keep on changing the video material, any reading material is. Yes, that is a very good question. With any reading material, so entire reading material will be shared by me with you in soft copy, and take the printout only what is required. Entire material will be shared by me. You don't have to spend even a single rupee extra for the study material. The fees. What should be the fees of the course? Now you can tell me what should be the fees of this course.
2,000
rupees. Are you studying for LKG or BK?
50,000.
Hmm. 50,000 should be the fees. Okay. Anybody else? What should be the fees of this course? 5,000. Hmm. Anybody else? 5,000. See, this is 100 hours of videos. Lots of webinars, lots of MCQs. There are courses available in the market. Only MCQs, 5,000 rupees. Only course material, 7,500 rupees. I am giving you course material free. I am giving you MCQ included in this. Webinar is also already included in that. This all that is coming at what price? As of today, this price is 10,000. Only 10,000, and this price will be there for very, very limited period. Right now, the link is already shared in the chat. Those who think that they should be joining, click on that, avail this piece. This piece will vanish within 2 days. After 2 days, this piece will never come back. My promise to you that this price is never, never going to be. And before the end of this year, that is 2021, this fees will become 20,000 rupees. That is my promise to you. So by investing today itself, you are directly saving your 50% money. By this end, by this year end, I will increase it to 20,000 rupees. Today itself, take the benefit. Interview preparation also, that is a separate course. But the, as far as the procedures are concerned, procedure will be covered therein. Now I tell you one thing. Check the courses, import-export procedure courses on online and check the fees thereof. They will give you the course import-export procedure, 20 hours, fees 20,000 rupees. No interaction, no webinar, no talking. I'm giving you everything that is a part of this.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Interview preparation course is separate, right?
Yes.
And what, I mean, how much is that for?
That is going to be almost same.
Okay, same. Thank you.
Or wo futuristic hai, wo aaj ke liye nahi hai. Once you clear the written exam, only then we talk about that.
Okay,
so, sir. What is important is that tomorrow, by chance, if you are not able to get the license, still the procedures are known to you, you can start working with somebody for import-export. Your employment opportunity is clear. Right? So, that this fees, I'm telling you, this will not be available again. This fees. Even today, if you look at the, in, go and check the app, you'll find what is the fees. That is 12,500 as of today. But today I'm giving you for 10,000 rupees, valid only for 2 days. Today and tomorrow evening. Tomorrow evening, 12 o'clock, this will go away. This fees will not be available again at any cost. Tell me, confirm how many of you are joining right now?
Any spot booking offer, sir?
This is the spot booking offer that is given to you that is valid for till tomorrow evening. Nothing less than this. Tomorrow evening, 12 o'clock, this offer will go. It will never come back again. Tell me quickly, how many of you are immediately going ahead? Click on the link and go ahead.
GST bills, sir, we will be getting.
Okay, sir.
GST is a part of that.
Including 10,000.
Yes. 10, GST is included in that.
Okay. We can get the GST bill now then?
Yes, you can get the GST invoice. If you're eligible, you can avail the credit for that amount. So it is inclusive of GST. If you have any questions, ask me as many questions as you want and join the group. If you have any question, ask me on the group. Because this fees will not be available after tomorrow. Let me confirm it to you again. And even if you, whatever request you make, that cannot be done because that is, everything is automated. Once the time is gone, it is gone. It will never come back again.
Sir?
Any questions?
Sir?
The link is there in the group, in the chat box.
Sir, whether any EMI options available to pay?
EMI option will be there. In